Okay, hi student, this is video number 6 for chapter 5.1 on the numeric filing. Okay, I have stopped for disadvantages of terminal or middle digits. We have a 2, another 2 will cover here. Okay, at which the next disadvantages is when there is a large block consecutively numbers folder. Okay, it's required. The filer must retrieve them from many locations throughout the filing system. This process can be time consuming. Okay, maksud dia, okay, sekiranya filer, which is the of the staff yang menguruskan proses filing and also retrieval, okay, dikehendaki untuk mencari, okay, mengeluarkan file yang mana file tu mengikut block of consecutively numbered folder. Okay, maksudnya kita nak mengikut susunan, okay, untuk hari ni kita nak keluarkan page record untuk patient yang hadir pada 25 hari bulan. So 25 hari bulan will be susunan nombor tu macam saya sebut tadi, nombor saya nombor belakang saya 60, nombor adik saya belakang dia 61. And then seterusnya mestilah 62, 63, 64, 65 dan seterusnya. Okay, pada hari yang sama. So bila kita nak cari balik, sebenarnya dia berada dalam tempat yang berbeza walaupun pada hari yang sama, sebab terminal digit menentukan dia punya shelf number ataupun dia punya drawer or the section number. That's why dia kena cari dekat banyak location dan akan menyebabkan time consuming. Okay, and the next one will be the transfer. Definitely the transfer of the inactive refiles will take longer time because there will be the various places for them to reach. Macam saya sebut tadilah. Okay, selanjutnya kalau kita sebut untuk inactive file, selanjutnya kita akan mengikut tahun. Okay, contohnya file yang dibuka pada 10 tahun yang sebelumnya telah 10 tahun yang lalu telah mencapai period of orang kata inactive record. So kita nak keluarkan file-file tersebut. Bila kita nak keluarkan, dia tak berada pada kedudukan tempat yang sama. Sebab again saya sebut tadi, shelf number dia dan drawer number dia berbeza memandangkan kalau kita guna terminal digit, which is nombor terakhir itu. Alright? Okay. And this is the tab number 4 for the numeric filing. Okay, at which we call it is a chronologic filing. Okay, what is the chronologic filing? It's actually the method of filing, numeric filing of the record at which you will arrange in the sequence of the dates. Okay, di mana awak menyusun file tersebut mengikut susunan tarikh. Di mana tarikh yang paling latest akan menyebabkan file tersebut berada di atas. Okay, with the most recent date on the top. Or forward sequence ataupun terbalik, which is with the earliest or the oldest date on the top. Okay, it will depend on your company. Sama ada you want to use a forward sequence ataupun on the sequence way. Alright, and either you use sama ada reverse ataupun forward punya sequence. Okay, reverse maksudnya tarikh paling latest dekat atas ataupun forward means that tarikh yang paling lama dekat atas. Right? Either you use both of it, each yang mana satu, but the primary guide caption will be the current year. Okay, as you can see here, it will divide on the year. All right, the primary guide. Okay, for example, here we are using the most recent year on the top, or which we call it as a reverse sequence. Okay, we have 2020, we have 2019, 2018, 2017 for the primary guide. Okay, and for primary guide caption. So, dalam di bawah 20 tahun 2020, okay, kita ada di mana secondary guide, this one. Okay, secondary guide for each of the month from January through December is placed behind the gear guide. So belakang 2020 ni kita akan masukkan this one what we call secondary guide daripada January sampailah di December. Not only that, untuk tahun 2019 pun kita akan ada this guide. We call month secondary guide ni, di mana dia ada 12 guide. 12 pembagi sebab kita ada 12 bulan. So, setiap tahun ni, di belakang tahun ni kita akan ada guide pembahagi lagi. Kita panggil secondary guide. Yang mana this secondary guide adalah caption daripada January kepada December. Alright? And the folder label caption also bear the month of the January to the December. This folder are filed behind the month guide. Contohnya, surat file tersebut dibuka pada bulan March tahun 2020. So, 20 tahun 2020 di bawah bulan March. Dan in fact, dalam bulan March ni juga, kita akan retrieve from the day of the month. Maksudnya, ada tarikh daripada satu hari bulan sampailah 31 hari bulan. So, that's why we call it as a chronologic filing. Okay, I think that's all for the what we call for numeric filing method. So in the next class, we are going to cover for the geographic record management. Okay, with that, thank you. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.